Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection. Our time for reflection leader today is Reverend David Watson, Minister, Cumbrae, Fairlie and Largs Parish Church.
Good afternoon, members of the Scottish Parliament. I came across a story many years ago, and I don't know whether it's historically accurate or not, but I've never been one to allow facts to get in the way of a good story. John Loudon McAdam was born in Ayr, and as a young man, he went to New York, where he made his fortune. He decided to return to his native Ayrshire, and as a self-made man, he was able to purchase a large estate. He had a passion for family history, and he spent a lot of time indulging his passion. He was writing a book about the McAdam family. The project became so all-consuming that he neglected his responsibilities as a landowner. The roads across the estate fell into such disrepair that he was threatened with legal action if he didn't do something about it. Annoyed at being forced to waste time on what he regarded as being a rather trivial task, John McAdam resolved to do the job properly so that he wouldn't be interrupted again. He had the existing road dug out completely. The trench was filled with big rocks and smaller stones and gravel, and finally a top dressing of finer material. Ditches were dug at each side for drainage. And when he was satisfied with the result, John Loudon McAdam went back to finish writing his family history. John McAdam built a road that stood up well to the elements, and we get a lot of elements in Ayrshire. Not only that, but it didn't become quickly rutted with the wheels of carts and carriages. In fact, it lasted so well that people came from miles around to see how he'd done it. As John McAdam's fame as a road builder grew, his design was copied throughout the world. The macadamised road became the standard for road building everywhere. Now, I don't know if John McAdam ever wondered what his legacy might be, but the thing for which he is remembered is not something which he regarded as being a priority. All of us would, I suspect, one way or another, like to make our mark. Very often, however, the projects to which we devote our time and energy turn out to be relatively unimportant in the grand scheme of things, whereas people, conversations, and tasks, which seemed inconsequential at the time, become our true legacy. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Reverend Watson.